This is part 8 of solving linear equations. We're just going to continue working through lots of different examples. All right, so let's do this one. Well, before trying to do the addition and multiplication properties of equations where you could add, multiply, or divide, or multiply the same number to both sides of an equation, we want to simplify the left-hand side because there's distributive property and here's a multiplication. So if we distribute the 3, this will give us 6, right? 3 times 2 minus 3 times 5x is negative 15x plus, and 4 times 6x is 24x. And the right hand's already simplified, so that's cool. Then we're going to see if we could add any like terms. And we have a negative 15x and a plus 24x. So 24x minus 15x will be 9x. And then I also have plus 6. Now we want to find out what x equals. So here's the x term, so I want to subtract 6 from both sides. So now we're doing the golden rule where you add or subtract the same number to both sides, giving a 9x is 6. And so since 9 times x is 6, you need to find out what x is by dividing both sides by 9. So our final answer, if we reduce this fraction 6/9 by dividing the top and bottom by 3, is 2/3. So it looks like that's the answer. All right, now we have to check it, of course. Let's check and see if that's correct. On a regular piece of paper, you could do it right next to the same problem, but you don't have that on this little video. I don't have enough space, so I'm going to have to do it underneath. So notice, I have to copy the exact same problem as it started out. And I'm going to see when I plug in 2/3 if I get the same number on both sides. So you underline the entire problem, go down from the equal sign with a bar, and then we're going to plug in 2/3 for x. Now, to be quite honest, checking could really be a pain with fractions, and that's life. That's how it is. I wish I could say it's easier. All right, so we're going to simplify the left-hand side, which means first you have to do inside parentheses. So I've got 2 minus 5 times 2/3. So I have to first, inside the parentheses, multiply 5 times 2/3. So I have 3. Do not do the distributive property, because that's not how you do order of operations when you have numbers. So this is 5 over 1 times 2 over 3. The good news is you get to practice your fractions. Now, inside this parentheses, I have 6 times 2/3, which is 4. You can cancel the 3 into the 6 and get 2 times 2, or you could think of that as 12/3. So in any case, what's inside the parentheses is going to be 4. Still have to do inside the parentheses over here on the left side. So we've got 2 minus 10/3 plus. And at this point, if you want, you could multiply the 4 times 4, since you're not going to add anyway till the very end of the problem. Now, how do you do 2 minus 10/3? You got to get a common denominator. So that would be 6/3 minus 10/3. That could be done over on the side to scratch, if you'd like. I'm just showing all the steps right here. So that's now finally 6/3 minus 10/3 is negative 4/3. So I'm going to just write that's going to be negative 4/3. I'm going to run out of space here. Okay. All right, so let's keep going. This gives us, the 3's cancel, negative 4 plus 16, right? Because the 3's cancel. Finally, negative 4 plus 16 is 12. Okay, now let's see. What was on the other side? Thank goodness, did all my arithmetic correct, and it's 12. What does that mean? That means x equals 2/3 is the correct answer, because it checked. So the answer is either 2/3, or the formal way is writing the answer in solution sets. Okay? And if you want, you can put a box around it just so somebody could find the answer. Wow. Ready for the next one? Right, here we have a problem where we have variables and constants on both sides. And on the right-hand side, we need to simplify by adding the two constants together as our first step. So we've got 6y minus 8 equals, well, we've got the 3y, but now we want to add the negative 6 and 13 together because those are like terms, and that gives us plus 7. All right, so we have variables and constants, so we have to choose which side to put the variable on. Let's keep the variables on the left side. So if I want the variables on the left side, I want to get rid of this minus 8, so we could take care of that by adding 8 to both sides, right? And at the same time, if the constants are going to be on the right, I want to get rid of the 3y on the right-hand side, so I want to subtract 3y from both sides. So by the way, my golden rule was I added, actually I'm going to write it as what I'm adding to both sides is simply a negative 3y plus 8 to both sides. Make sure that you add the same number. Remember GR means the golden rule. I'm just showing you what I'm adding to both sides of the equation. So we've got 3y on this side because the minus 8 and plus 8 cancels. And 7 plus 8 is 15. Yeah, we could divide both sides by 3. So y equals 5. All right, that looks correct. But of course, we need to check it. Okay, so let's go ahead and check it. Remember, we copy the original problem down. Underline it all. Separate the left side and the right side with this bar. And then we're going to plug in 5 for y. So we have 6 times 5 minus 8 is 30 minus 8. So the left-hand side of the equation simplifies to 22. And on the right side, we're going to plug in 5 for y. And again, do order of operations. Negative 6 plus 15 plus 13. So you could add the 15 and 13 first if you like, or you can go left to right, and since addition is commutative and associative, you could have your choice of which way you go. So they both simplify to 22, so y equals 5 is the correct answer. Remember, when you check it, plug it in the original equation and plug in the numbers and only do the order of operation. So the answer is 5. That was the correct answer, or you can use the solution. It doesn't look very good. Solution set. Here's another problem with fractions. Let's go over this one. All these denominators, I'm going to do this by multiplying by the least common denominator. So both sides of the equation, I'm going to multiply by the least common denominator of 3, 4, and 2, which is 12. So I need to multiply 12 times every term on both sides. So you're doing 12 times 2 thirds, 12 times 3 fourths, minus 12 times 1 half x. So you could think of it as distributing this 12 on both sides of the equation. All right, so let's go ahead and cancel. We've got 3 goes into 12 4 times, so that's 4 times 2 is 8. There's your equal sign. 4 goes into 12 3 times, so 3 times 3 is 9. And 2 goes into 12 6 times, remember that minus sign, so it's minus 6x. So notice by multiplying by the least common denominator, I ended up clearing the fractions and having only integers now. All right, so we want to go on from here. So there's a couple ways we could do this. I'm going to do this by adding 6x to both sides so that I have it on the left side of the equation, that variable, and it'll be positive. So I want to add 6x to both sides, but notice there's no place over here to add it to another x, so I'm just going to write it right here. All right, so we're going to have our variable on this side, so I need to get rid of the 8 by subtracting 8 from both sides. So notice I am adding exactly the same thing to both sides. So we end up with 6x equals 1, and then we simply divide by 6. So So our answer is 1/6, and you can check that. So here's the check. This side is just 2/3. The other side is 3/4 minus 1/2 times 1/6. You have to get a common denominator over here. We've got 3/4 minus 1/12, so you need to get a common denominator. 9/12 minus 1/12 is 8/12, which reduces to 2/3. So it does check. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.